up at number 10, we have Jennifer Lawrence. Jennifer Lawrence deeply regrets her tattoo, and after seeing pictures of it, I completely understand why. She decided to get the tattoo because her co-star in The Hunger Games, Liam Hemsworth, convinced her to get a tattoo of the symbol for water, H2O, which is incredibly random. And the tattoo did not come out as planned, and I'm not sure how it looked in the draft, but it looks seriously ridiculous. The tat is on her hand right in between her thumb and her first finger, and when talking about the tattoo, she said, quote, "I was with Liam Hemsworth's family and everybody was getting tattoos. And I was like, well, I'm always gonna need to be hydrated, so I guess I should get H2O on my hand. By the way, I know that the 2 is high in the H2O, the 2 is supposed to be low. I should have Googled it before I got the tattoo on my body forever." Also, the fact that she used red or brown dye, I can't tell which, probably didn't help the look of it either. Also, before we get into the next one, make sure to like the video if you're liking it so far. And at number 10, we have Armie Hammer. Armie Hammer was recently exposed for very obscure and disturbing fetishes, including allegedly being a cannibal. And a big part of the reason the accusations picked up steam was because his accuser had pictures of him with a tattoo that made him identifiable. The anonymous account that accused him of indecent behavior, called House of Effie, first released allegations against Armie. And when people didn't believe this user, she then posted a photo that Armie allegedly sent to her, which showed a hand tattoo identical to the one that the actor has. The picture showed a hand along with the script on a table. The disturbing messages are thought to have been sent between 2016 and February of 2020, while Armie was still married to Elizabeth Chambers. And I'm sure after getting exposed, he wishes that he did not have that identifying tattoo.
Starting us off at number 10 is Gucci Mane. In 2011, he started showing off a new tattoo to his collection. It would be impossible to hide it because he got it on his face, taking up the majority of his cheek. He got an ice cream cone with 3 scoops of ice cream and the word "brr" written on it. At the time, everyone was dying to know what it meant, and his spokesperson Callie Bauer said, "It's a reminder to his fans on how he chooses to live his life, cool as ice, as in, I'm so icy, I'll make you say brr." The ice cream cone itself, that is so dumb, oh my god. The ice cream cone itself was designed after a medallion that Gucci wore for years. It was actually showing up all over the place, like on all his red carpet events and all of his pictures. He always wore this big ice cream necklace.
And at number 9, we have Mark Wahlberg. Mark Wahlberg has a few large tattoos on his muscular body. And I understand if you didn't know he had tattoos because you were, you know, distracted. But apparently when he started to get more serious about his acting, he decided to get the tattoos removed. The reason is because he didn't want to spend extra time in hair and makeup getting them removed. Plus, he added that he doesn't want his kids getting tattoos, and he doesn't want to be a hypocrite when he tells them not to get it. And to make a point of how much he regrets the tattoos, he actually took his 2 older kids with him to get the tattoos removed, telling People magazine, "I've taken my 2 older kids to the procedure so they see how painful it is and what I had to go through. And based on what I've heard about getting tattoos removed, I'm sure it was a painful enough process to deter his kids from getting them forever."
In at number 9, Tallulah Willis. Actor Tallulah Willis says she regrets getting a tattoo on her left arm when she was 20. The tattoo was of a creature called Scouter that she got on her arm after doodling it on an airplane and getting it as soon as she landed. She later said on Instagram that she regretted the tattoo, and apparently at that age, she didn't understand what the word permanent meant. She ended up getting the tattoo removed and posted a photo of the bandaged arm to her Instagram, with the caption reading, quote, "Tattoos are fun until they are not. Thankful that Magic Lasers for Skin exists. Disclaimer, my arms are burning as deep as my ego, but it really does work." That seemed like a word of warning to her followers to not get impulsive tattoos.
Up next, number 9 is Nicole Richie. I don't think anything makes you feel more regret than tattooing the word virgin on your body. She was only 16 when she got the tattoo, and she said at the time that it seemed like a good idea. So did mine at 16, Nicole. It really didn't have anything to do with sex either. It was actually about her sign. She talked about her tattoo during an interview and said, "I'm a Virgo, so when I was 16, I thought, oh, I'm gonna be different and I'm gonna put virgin because the virgin is the sign for Virgo." She joked and said that she thought about adding an I and an A and then telling people she's from Virginia. I mean, that's clever, but like, why wouldn't you just laser it off at this point? Like, she's still just rocking it all these years. I would laser that off.
And at number 8, Adam Levine. Adam Levine is known for his tattoos that are practically all over his body. So it's kind of a shock to me that he would have any regrets at all, but it seems that even if a lot of your body is taken up by tattoos, you still want to make sure every one is perfect, of course. And although Levine likes most of his tattoos, one he got of a Russian prison tattoo was not a winner. And even though he loved the design, when it was tattooed on his shoulder, it didn't look how he'd hoped. And he told Anderson Cooper, it looked like a cauliflower with the sun in the middle of it. It's just despicable looking. And instead of getting it removed, he added an eye to the center of it, and it looks slightly better now.
And at number 8, Jessica Alba. Jessica Alba has multiple tattoos on her body, but she says she only regrets 2. The first is a lower back tattoo, which she called, quote, kind of a tramp stamp up above. Then there is another image of flowers on her neck that Alba says, quote, I got when I was like 17, and I'm so irritated that I got it. Alba hates the neck tattoo so much that she's tried to get it removed multiple times, but for whatever reason, it has not come off. So I guess really think before getting any tattoos, because they don't always come off.
Coming into number 8 is Drake. He made headlines in 2017 for getting a tattoo of his favorite beauty product. A tattoo artist shared the first picture of the tattoo, which is on his shoulder. It's a tattoo of his favorite cologne by Guy LaRoche called Drakkar Noir. I'm probably saying that like so bad, but you get the idea. The iconic men's scent was part of the bestseller circa in 1991. It's been said that there is like a deeper meaning to the cologne, and apparently people who wear it are behind the times due to the cultural diffusion at the time when it first came out. That tattoo isn't that random though, because apparently the rapper's original Twitter handle was Drakkar D. Noir. So he's been a dedicated fan of this cologne for a while now. I mean, I still wouldn't get a tattoo of it, but.
And at number 7, Demi Lovato. Demi Lovato has had a ton of tattoos, and she got them all in a pretty short amount of time after her Disney days, and since I haven't really kept up with her since then, I honestly had no idea she had that many tattoos. But she admitted in an appearance on Live with Kelly and Michael that she wishes she hadn't gotten more than 12 tattoos before she turned 20. And when you put it like that, it's a lot of tattoos. The one she regrets most is a tattoo of one of her friend's lips on the inside of her arm, with her saying that it was a stupid spur of the moment decision. And instead of getting it removed, she would work the lips into a rose.
And at number 7, Pete Davidson. Pete Davidson became a household name during his whirlwind romance with Ariana Grande. And since both of them are obsessed with tattoos, they both inked their love for each other in multiple regrettable tattoos. Pete got a huge tattoo on his neck of bunny ears, inspired by the Dangerous Woman aesthetic. Then after they broke up, he had that tattoo turn into a massive black heart. Not subtle at all. But this was not the only Ariana-inspired tattoo that Pete covered up. Pete and Ari got matching neck tattoos that said, Mille Tendresses. The saying is French and means a thousand tendernesses. But Pete got it covered up with huge black letters that said, Cursed. I think that's all the proof that we need that the relationship did not end well.
Spooky. Sliding to number 7 is Ariana Grande. Her song Seven Rings was the number one song in the country for a while back in 2019. To celebrate the success of her song, she decided to get a tattoo on her hand of Chinese symbols spelling out seven rings. She posted the picture of it to her Instagram, and the two Chinese symbols she got roughly translate to seven rounds or seven wheels in Chinese. But the Twitter universe was quick to point out that the Japanese kanji translation means small barbecue grill. Ariana ended up responding and said that she left off a number of characters in the translation because it hurt so bad and she wouldn't have lasted another symbol. In the end, she deleted the original Instagram post, tweeted that she likes tiny barbecue grills, and got it fixed by adding in another symbol.
And at number 6, 50 Cent. 50 Cent's reason for getting his tattoos removed is very similar to Mark Wahlberg's. Even though 50 loves his tattoos and they're a staple of his brand for years, he started removing most of his tattoos in 2010 when he started to pursue acting and putting music on the back burner. And the reason is one that we have heard before, with him saying, it cuts down on the amount of time I have to spend in makeup covering them up, he told People. But he didn't get rid of every single one of his tattoos, and he still has one on his back. And considering how many tattoos 50 has, to get those removed must have taken a ton of time and resulted in a lot of pain.
And at number 6, Ariana Grande. Speaking of Ariana, she has gotten some regrettable non-Pete related tattoos as well. The worst was when she tried to get seven rings in Japanese characters on her palm. But after she got the tattoo, she learned that it was botched, and the tattoo actually translated more closely to, quote, tiny charcoal grill. She ended up getting it fixed, but sadly did not read what she wanted, because after the touch-up, the tattoo read Japanese barbecue finger. Ari then went on to explain all the spelling mishaps were because she could not stand the pain of the tattoo, and she didn't even mind because the tattoo would just peel over time anyways.
Cruising into number 6, we have Kaylee Cuoco. In 2016, she announced her divorce from the former pro tennis player Ryan Sweeting. But with this news also came other news that she would need to get a tattoo covered up, which was linked to her wedding. When she was with Ryan, she tattooed their wedding date on the back of her neck in Roman numerals. For obvious reasons, she couldn't keep flaunting that on her body for like the rest of her life. I mean, she could, but she didn't want to, so she decided to cover it up with a giant moth. She spoke about it on The Ellen Show and said, "The wedding tattoo was a mistake. I had to cover it. I had to cover it with the wings, which I think turned out okay." She said she picked a moth like over a butterfly because the wings were bigger and she needed bigger to cover up the numbers.
Halfway number 5, Kelly Osbourne. Kelly Osbourne is known for her many tattoos, but back in 2010, seemingly out of nowhere, she announced that she started the process to have almost all of her 15 tattoos removed. Now, one word for that, ouch. When talking about the decision, she said, "Some still have a special meaning, like the matching ones my brother Jack and I have. Some were a mistake." She said that she got the idea to remove the tattoos when she was working on the film Should Have Been Romeo. And when the makeup artist covered up her ink, she said she didn't really miss them, with her adding, "I met up with my dermatologist and I'll start the laser treatment as soon as I have time," the Dancing with the Stars alum said, with her acknowledging that the process will take several months. And while she's not looking forward to the pain, she says that apparently it hurts less than the actual tattoo, so she has some hope.
Halfway number 5, Khloe Kardashian. The Kardashian sisters lost their father when they were all pretty young, but Khloe was a teenager at the time and seemed to take it the hardest. To grieve with the pain, she got 2 tattoos to honor her father. One was the words, quote, "I love you," on her wrist, written in her dad's handwriting. But the other was a lower back tattoo with a cross and angel wings, with the word "daddy" written above it. When talking about the removal, she said, quote, "I should have listened to Sister Kim when she told me you don't put a bumper sticker on a Bentley." Khloe got the tattoo when she was just 16, and she says that she likes the tattoo, but quote, "on my lower back, I don't like the location. I got a trendy location, it's called Tramp Stamp." Khloe even filmed the removal of it in an Instagram video.
Halfway through the countdown is Kat Von D. The broken engagement to Jesse James was heavily documented, and so was the tattoo of his face that she had on the side of her ribs. She had one of his childhood photos tattooed on her as a way to surprise him and show him her commitment and love. When they first split, she said she was going to keep it because the school portrait of him in 5th grade had more meaning to it than just being a portrait. But her feelings on the tattoo changed, and she later posted photos of her getting laser removal. More details about their split later came to surface, and she said that he cheated on her with 19 other women.
And at number 4, Pharrell Williams. The legendary music producer had 2 full sleeve tattoos before he decided to get them removed. All of a sudden, Pharrell realized he didn't want the tattoos anymore because they represented his adolescence, saying in an interview, "It's going to be pricey, but it's worth it. I got fire on my arms. I don't need fire on my arms. I'm a grown man." Since he has so many tattoos, he was considering getting a skin graft for the removal and placing the skin over the tattoos, but he opted for a laser instead. And he showed a picture on his blog of both of his arms covered in bandages with the caption, "Laser treatment, extra crispy, see, no skin graft here, just pure laser paint. This is our own version of Mythbusters, laser is the new primer." In addition to using laser removal to get rid of his entire sleeve of tattoos, he had new skin grown in a test tube, so it could be used to cover up his arms. And if I was ever considering getting a tattoo, this story just like took that urge completely away.
In at number 4, Amy Schumer. The comedian got a tattoo in the Tramp Stamp location, and even though she has regrets about it, she has not expressed that she will be removing it. And the tattoo is such an integral part about her that she even named her book after it, with the name of the book simply being, quote, "The Girl with the Lower Back Tattoo." But she's self-aware that the tattoo has a lot of critics, with her even taking a picture of it for Instagram and using the hashtag, quote, "Yes, I know my tattoo sucks," in the picture.
Up next, number 4 is Ryan Cabrera. Every tattoo tells a story, and this is one for the books. The singer tattooed a portrait of Ryan Gosling's face on his leg and says it is not going anywhere because he is proud of it. It has nothing to do with like a man crush or being a huge fan of the actor's work. It was actually just part of a game. Ryan explained and said, "We like to play a game called Tattoo Roulette. roulette. We blindfold each other. You get to pick a tattoo for me, and I get to pick a tattoo for you, and you don't get to see it till they're both done. When asked if the tattoo bothers him at all, he said not at all, and that he thinks it's funny.
And at number three, Nicole Richie. Nicole Richie decided to get a tattoo of her name, along with red ribbons, on the high part of her neck. But she instantly regretted it when she realized it was easily seen with short hair, saying, "I was an idiot," for getting a neck tattoo, which is still visible when she had short hair. She also got virgin tattooed on her wrist to give a nod to her Virgo status, saying the tattoo was embarrassing and desperate. Adding, "I am a Virgo, so when I was 16, I thought, ooh, I'm gonna be different and I'm gonna put virgin because the virgin is the sign for Virgo." And I think this is just a lesson to think that kind of thing through before making a permanent decision like that. I mean, I'm a Virgo too, I get it, but I'm not tattooing it either.
And at number three, Justin Bieber. Justin has been in the same predicament as a lot of people over the years, and that's getting a tattoo inspired by your ex. But Justin took it a touch farther and basically got a picture of his ex Selena Gomez on his arm with angel wings behind her. And he has admitted that he regrets it. In an interview with GQ, he hinted that he only regrets one tattoo, saying, quote, "This is my ex-girlfriend. I kind of tried to cover up her face with some shading, but people still know." And looking at images of the tattoo recently, the Selena tattoo still looks as similar to her as it ever did. But thankfully, he has so many tattoos, he won't have to pay this one much attention, hopefully.
Taking over the third spot is Pete Davidson, another celebrity to get a tattoo related to their spouse. When he was dating Ariana Grande, he got her bunny ear symbol tattooed behind one of his ears. He seemed pretty committed to her with the tattoo, so much that he even proposed to her after just like a few months or weeks of dating. After Ariana ended things and called off the engagement, he had to cover it up with something. Because the original tattoo was just like a lot of colored in black, he didn't have much to work with, so he got this big plain black heart to fill in like the shape of the bunny ears. But like, you know the shape of bunny ears, like the heart just, it don't look like the right heart. It's just a little off. I'm sure it's not ideal for him, but it works. I probably would have just left the bunny ears.
And at number two, Jessie J. Jessie J made the very mature decision to call out her bad tattoo before anybody else could, when she decided to expose herself on Instagram. In a funny Instagram post that included a picture of her in a bikini, she admitted that there was a spelling mistake on her tattoo, with it reading, "Don't lose who you are in the blur of the stars," lyrics from one of her own songs. And her tattoo used the double O for loose, not lose. And apparently the mistake is why she wears everything high-waisted. And joking further about the mistake, she added, "I still don't know the difference between lose and loose." And because I wasn't sure of the difference either, honestly, loose is with two O's, you know, when something isn't tight, and then lose is when you've lost something just with one O. So it looks like I'm not only giving you celeb news, but some grammar lessons too. You're welcome, guys.
And at number two, Kaylee Cuoco. Kaylee Cuoco decided to tattoo all the dates related to her relationship with her ex, Ryan Sweeting, on her upper back. She put the dates of their courtship, engagement, and wedding in huge Roman numerals. But Kaylee quickly regretted the decision, as the couple did not last and got a divorce shortly after. And only 2 months after the divorce was announced, Kaylee was already planning how to cover up the tattoo. The tag is now a huge flying insect, and she posted a picture of the transformation online, saying in the caption, quote, "Thank you, Neuroset and Studio City Tattoo, for helping me right my wrongs. Note to self, do not mark your body with any future wedding dates. Hashtag under 30 mistakes and hashtag don't take yourself too seriously, kids." She later posted the finished product with the caption reading, quote, "The deep, meaningful, larger-than-life meaning behind this beautiful piece of ink is, it covered the last one." At least she's very lighthearted about the whole situation.
Rolling into number two is T-Pain. Some would say the rapper has a lot of style and swag, but this tattoo questions a lot of that. Back in 2011, he tweeted out a picture of his new tattoo, and it was the Facebook like button on his forearm. He tweeted, "I get a tat every time I come to Hawaii. I think this one is pretty sweet, unless Facebook shuts down soon." The full tattoo says, "You don't have to like me," and he put his own spin on it by changing the like to like the Facebook like button. You can imagine what people were commenting about it, but he was not fazed. He stands by the tattoo and thinks it is clever, unless Facebook shuts down, of course.
And at number one, Sarah Hyland. Sarah Hyland got a tattoo I think anyone would regret, and that was a matching tattoos of a dinosaur on her butt with her best friend. And she flashed it in an Instagram post she made in 2017, writing the caption, "We believe in dinosaurs." But after that post, she followed it up with another showing that she was having a tattoo removed. And although she didn't explicitly state that the dinosaur was the one getting removed, I think we can all assume it was that one. And I don't even want to imagine how much it would hurt to get that tattoo, let alone get it removed. Like, just the whole thing is a no from me, dog. So that's the list, everyone. What are you thinking down below? Who do you think had the worst tattoo on this list? And I am dying to know, do you guys have any tattoos that you regret? I personally don't have any tattoos and I've never really thought of getting one, but after this list, there is like no way Jose.
And finally, number one, Hayden Panettiere. Hayden Panettiere had an unfortunate mishap with her tattoo. She got the phrase, quote, "live without regrets" tattooed on the side of her ribcage in Italian. But the irony is that she actually got the tattoo misspelled, so she decided to get it removed. Clearly, there was some regrets. With her starting the removal process 4 years after she got it, she spoke about the tattoo in an interview, where she revealed that she got it because her dad showed her at a young age that when one door closes, another one always opens. Adding, quote, "so my tattoo means live without regrets. It's not that you don't regret things in life, but you at least try to learn from them. It's misspelled too, so I literally have to live by that advice." And at least she seemed to be a good sport about it, but the tattoo is now removed.
Winning the number one spot on our list is Ryan Gosling. Nothing is worse than a tattoo that is not done by a professional. Ryan decided that he would get a home tattoo kit and give himself a tattoo on his forearm. You may not have ever noticed, but there is a tattoo on his left arm that looks like a weird cactus thing. Turns out that he did the tattoo himself and said it was supposed to be a monster's hand dropping a bloody heart. But it did not turn out that way at all. I mean, he gets an A for effort, but honestly, it's like probably the ugliest thing I've ever seen and looks nothing like a monster's hand dropping a bloody heart. But it's Ryan Gosling, so he's still cute though.